A very good afternoon to one and all present here in this fourth international e-conference on fingerprint analysis. Myself Anjali Tamgadge, MSc first year student from Government Institute of Forensic Science, Nagpur, Maharashtra. From the last 2 days, with the help of this conference, we have all seen various different approaches in this field of forensic fingerprint. And this is one approach from my side in the form of e-poster presentation on the topic fingerprint from disease. Let us start. Firstly, with the introduction, as we all know, fingerprint is the most important evidence in today's world. It is the means of personal identification and individualization. However, there is certain cases such as mass disaster, violent crimes, accident, drowning, where the identity of dead body cannot be clearly established. Either the facial characteristics may have destroyed, or there are no other clues available for the identification of this. This is in all such cases, the use of fingerprints are important to trace their identities. To use the fingerprint, we must first record. So now moving towards the process of recording, the process is somewhat different than that of the living. And here is the series of procedure that is need to be followed while recording. Also, before starting to record, it is advised to complete all the pathological examination of hands and finger, as there may be certain evidence or traces of evidence that may get contaminated with the process of recording or with the ink or some chemicals that we may use. So before starting, firstly, in the process, there is the primary visual examination is carried out to note the condition of hands and fingers, their steps also. If they have any dirt, soil, in all such cases, we have to wash the hands with the help of soap or alcohol also we can use, or the hot waters that we can use. Hot water here provides two benefits, that it makes the fingertip flexible, or also it can be dried up quickly. As there is no body heat, we have to dry the fingers manually. Then the next step is to photograph. It is to have the evidence of evidence states in which we have collected the fingerprints, also for the future references. It is advised to take the mid as well as the close-up photography of the hands. Now, the next step is to decide the method of recording. This is the step where it differs from the living. Here, we have to decide which procedure to be followed depending upon the stage at which body or fingerprints are. The stages can be the stage one as a recent death stage, stage two, that is rigor mortis stage, stage three, that is decomposition stage. Now let us look at them one by one. Stage one is the recent death stage, where the death has occurred recently or within the few hours has passed off, or it we may consider 4 to 7 hours have passed. In this stage, the fingerprint recording is mostly similar than as that of the living. We may use fingerprint pad method. Here, single digit pad is advised over the conventional bigger one. And here, a pad is rolled over the fingers. It differs in living as we roll fingers over the pad and the roll impressions are taken. Whereas in the moderately flexible fingers, where it is moving towards the rigor mortis, we can use the ink method, where the horizontal roller is used to ink the finger. And with the help of fingerprint spatula, which is embedded with the fingerprint card or some papers as given in the picture, we can use. The next is where the fingers are rigid. We can use the powder and the tape method. It is same as we were using for the lifting method. Then the stage two is the rigor mortis has established or it is onset due to the fusion of myosin and actin filament in the muscle that forms the actomyosin, which makes the muscle stiff. In this case, primary approach should be to straighten the fingers. So this can be done by the three ways, by pressing at the knuckle zones, or we can use the fingerprint straightener as in the picture, or we can perform certain exercise like bend the wrist in the direction of forearm with the finger close to the palm. If all the above fails and the rigor mortis is for the longer duration of time, we have to follow the consider the following two cases. If it is shrunken or wrinkled, then we can inject the suitable fluids to restore the original state. First is we can use the hot water, as I have explained earlier. We can insert the melted paraffin wax, oil, air in shrunken cases, we have to insert the air with the help of needle, and we have to massage that area for few minutes to close the perforated spot. Then a mixture of gelatin and glycerin in the ratio 1:7 volume by volume has proven to be most effective in this case. Then the next case is of hard and rough fingers, where the body has exposed to very hot climate for longer duration of time. The fingers becomes hard and rough. In this case, we have to ampute the digits with a bone spine as given in the picture, and then we have to soak it into the potassium hydroxide separately with labeling of each container, then in the formaldehyde, or we can use the ammonium hydroxide weak alkali. As in case of potassium hydroxide, it is the strong alkali and that may damage the rich characteristic. Therefore, weak alkali like ammonium hydroxides are advised to use. However, the process is a bit longer and we have a tedious one. In this, starting with the 50% of ammonium hydroxide, we have to soak the amputated fingers for 24 hours, then further increasing to 75% for next 24 hours, then to 100% solution for the next 24 hours, and stop at the stage where you can get the desired result. And also, this method of using ammonium hydroxide has been successfully employed in one of the cases to identify the 3-month-old dumb body. Then we can also use the ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid EDTA to inflate the fingers. Rather than this, we can also use the chemicals such as commercially available like Metaflo and Restorative. Metaflo is the pre-injection fluids that increases the cell permeability, as well as Restorative that rehydrate the desiccated tissue. So the advantage of using this type of mixture is that they neither damages the rich characteristic nor extensive monitorings are also required. So this is proven to identify the 14-year-old dead body after the 2 months of her death. Now stage 3 is the most difficult stage to collect the fingerprint. Only small part may persist in the rich pattern. So in this case, we have to peel off the skin. We may use xylene solution in this case, and we have to place it in the formaldehyde so as to stop the further decomposition and harden. Then the peel is placed on the examiner's own hand. Then the roll impressions are taken. Then the next case where the epidermis is broken and the inner skin persists the rich design. So that the same thing we have seen in the presentation of the Pujit sir, where they have taken the skin peel and water to identify the fingerprints. Then if all fails and is the extreme case where the tissue is decomposed badly, X-ray photography can also be used. In this case, we have to use the barium sulfate and lead carbonate to insert into finger. Then the X-rays are taken and the photographs of X-ray shows the bone structure in addition to their rich characteristics. So with this, we can say that the method is decided based on the circumstances that has leading to the death, as well as the extent, how they extend the postmortem changes have occurred, like their rigor mortis, deterioration, and dehydration. Then the next step is to record the multiple fingerprints. It is advised to, in case of deceased, to record the multiple fingerprints of single digit, as in one instance, we may not get the exact or the desired result. So it is advised to take the multiple fingerprints. So now moving towards the case, it is the case solved by the FBI, where the woman was found dead in the hotel and successfully identified by the close relatives. And after a month, same woman was seen by some of the relatives and informed the authority. With the prior permission, they examined the body and fingerprints was collected. They were compared in the database and found that the woman was someone else. Now, moving towards the conclusion, I would like to give my concluding remark by giving the data from FBI and NCRB. FBI has shown that in the 12-month period, they have 1,700 cases of unknown death, and 12 out of that, 1,298 was solved. This is the 76% of the total. And in NCRB, according to the 2012 data, on an average, there are 103 unidentified dead body per day is encountered. So it is the need of our to collect the fingerprint from deceased and successfully identify them, as we have seen in the methods. Many other methods are cumbersome, but they are successfully employed. So at last, I say faces can lie, but fingerprints never. Thank you.